Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this save the date postcard in Word. Now, this is fully customizable. You don't have to stick to these details. The concept is there, but you can change all of the backgrounds. You can change the font, you can change the colors, all sorts of stuff. So I'm going to show you how to do that with all the tools and tricks in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is to hop onto the internet, and we're going to go to a website called pixabay.com. You can see it up here. And in the search bar, I'm going to type in heart patterns. Then at the end here on the drop down, I'm going to select vectors. And then just place my cursor at the end of my search and press enter. Now you can choose from a wealth of different patterns. And this is what really allows you to customize your change the date card as much as you like. I'm going to hop onto page 2 and I'm going to go down and select this image here. Now you can see there are these grey and white checkers at the back of this image, and that means that this doesn't have a background. So you can put this on any colour card you like and you will just have these lovely scribbles of hearts in the background. So I click on free download, I'm going to click on vector graphic and click download. So back in Word, we're just going to go to insert, pictures, click on the drop down and select picture from file. Now I'm on my downloads here. I'm just going to click on the heart and select insert. Now the next thing we need to do is to make sure our page is the correct size. So let's go to layout and let's go to size here. Click on the drop down and you can select from any size page you like. So I'm going to go down to the bottom and I'm going to select postcard. And then I'm going to go to orientation, click on the drop down and select landscape. Let's just zoom in. And then in order to move this graphic, we've got to select it, go to graphics format, go to wrap text, click on it and go down to in front of text. And now we can move this graphic and we're going to go to one of the corners and we're going to pull it all the way out so it stretches all the way across our postcard. And then you can move this around until it suits your needs. And then we're going to go up and insert another graphic. So insert, shapes, click on the drop down, and we're going to select this rounded edge rectangle and click, and just click and drag out a rectangle. Don't worry too much about the size at the moment. Just make sure it's big enough to have some words in the center of it. And for this, we need to turn it white and take off the borderline that we have with every shape. So I'm going to go to shape format. If you find that shape format isn't there, it's because you haven't selected your shape. Go to shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline. And go to shape fill, click on the drop down and select white. We can use this little yellow box here and we can actually move. In fact, let's just go back and turn that red. We can use this little yellow box here to actually adjust those corners. And for this, because it's white, it won't show up so much, but I'm going to take it to out there and then turn that white again. Then I'm going to go to insert, text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box, click and drag out a text box. In the text box, I'm going to type save the date and then I'm going to select my text, go to the home tab and I'm going to go to my fonts, click on the drop down and I'm going to select this Belania font here. Now this is a font that I downloaded and if you want to check out how to do that, I'll leave a link in the description below for the video of how to do that. It's really quick and simple, it's not difficult. Select that and then I'm also going to go to my increase font size tool here, click until the size suits your taste. Again, don't worry too much about where to place it because we'll sort the alignment out at the end. And then I'm going to place this text in the center of my text box so it'll all be centered at the end. Now with every text box, it will come with a black border and a white background. So if I move this over here and just deselect it, you can see there's a white background and a black border. So we'll get rid of both of those. You don't have to, but I'm going to get rid of them. Select the text box, go to shape format, go to shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline, click on shape fill and select no fill. and then we've got a perfectly transparent box. Then I'm going to copy and paste this box by selecting it, holding down my Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging. And then in this box here, I'm going to place the date. And then deselect, reselect this box. I don't have to select the text if my cursor is not in the box. I'm going to go up to the Home tab. I'm going to change my font to Arial. And I'm going to reduce the size of it using this Reduce Font Size tool here. Reduce the size of the box. Just pull that down. I'm actually going to increase the size of this text here. So again, increase text size there. There we go. And now I'm going to copy and paste a few of these boxes because we need some for all of the information. So I'm going to pull out this one and then holding down my Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging again. So for this text box, I'm just going to select all the text and then just type. Do the same here. I'm going to choose to use the return key on this one. Make sure you've got the right text box. Okay, this one's being a pain, so let's just move that one out of the way. I'm going to reduce the size of this and in the middle and make it all caps. So go to the Home tab, select all the text, go to the Home tab. I'm going to reduce the size of it using Decrease Font Size tool here. And then going to this icon here, change case, click on the drop down and select uppercase. And just reduce the size of that again. And then just make sure this box is as small as possible. There we go. And here we're just going to put invitation to follow. Okay, so now let's line everything up and just change a few font sizes. So I'm going to change this font size, select it, go to the Home tab, and reduce that font size down. Again, reduce the size of this box. And then I'm also going to change the font size of this one, just reduce that one down. Now I'm just going to zoom out using this tool at the bottom here, bottom right. I'm just going to zoom out just to see how that looks. Sometimes you can't see any faults with it unless you zoom out. So save the date's a bit too low. So I'm going to use that the arrow keys just to move that up. Going to move that up as well. I'm actually going to move this box down. In fact, let's select this box, go to Shape Format, go to Align, select Align to Center, which will mean it'll line up center to your background, and then Align to Middle will make sure that it's aligned this way as well. So now that's all perfectly lined up to the middle, we can make proper adjustments to this. Okay, once you're happy with that, I'm just going to put some lines in that might add a bit of interest. I might just extend this background here. I'm quite happy with that. Again, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. That will ensure that white background section there is perfectly lined up again. I'm going to move that one down. Okay, so let's now select all of these boxes. So select this one, hold down your Command or Control key, select all the other boxes, and go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center. And that will ensure they're all lined up central to each other, but not to the page. So you have to go back up to Group, select Group. That will mean they're all one element, and then go up to Align and select Align to Center. That will ensure that all of your words are lined up to the center of your page. If you need to make some adjustments, just simply select it, go to Shape Format, Group, and select Ungroup. And we're just going to go and add some lines. So go to Insert, Shapes, Line. Click, hold down your Shift key and drag over to the right. That will ensure that it's perfectly horizontal or perfectly vertical. Select it, go to Shape Format, and click on Format Pane. Once you click on Format Pane, you'll come across this bucket icon here. Go down to line, which is the line that we've selected. It's got two little green balls either side. I'm going to change the color of the line to black. I'm going to change the width of it to 1 and press enter. Slightly thicker line, and now it's black. I'm going to copy and paste that by selecting it, holding down the Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging. There we go. I've selected them both, so now I can go to Align and select Align to Center. That will align them both to each other, but to align to the page, group them, then select Align to Center, and that will ensure that those two are lined up into the middle of your page. So let's zoom out again, see if we're happy with all the alignment. Perfect. Now, as I said, you can make all the customizations you want to. You can change the background, you can alter the colors, you can change the fonts, increase and decrease the size of the fonts, and really make it your own. But I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.